Good morning, all of my dear students. Welcome back to your online class. And in previous class, we have already just discussed about electric cell and electric circuit and what are the main things which are required to make an electric circuit. Now, can you write in your chat box to make an electric circuit, which things are necessary? Please write in your chat box. Everyone, what are the main things which are needed to make an electric circuit? Write in your chat box first. I want to see. Yes, I am fine. Stay blessed, everyone. You all. Very good, Deepak. Electric cell, bulb, wires, and switch. Now, tell me one thing. What is the main switch that I have already told you in previous class? What is the main function of switch? What is the main function of switch? I have already told you. What is the main function of switch? Yes, write down in your chat box. Very good, Ashmita, Tanaz, you have answered. Very good, Deepak, switch is used for on and off condition. Means mainly switch is a device that is used to break or to connect the electric circuit. Understood? So this is up to this portion we have discussed in previous class in a just elaborative way. Now and we have also seen what is an electric bulb and its functioning, its working, no? And how with the by seeing the diagram that switch is on or off, we have seen there are different symbols for switch on and switch off, no? Now we have also drawn on an electric circuit, okay? Page number, yes, I am telling, page number, that is 121. Everyone, page number 121, okay? Now, today we will see the figure of our torch. That is, you can already see from your book, page number 121, that is a picture. Can you see the picture of a torch? Can you see it properly? No? Now, this picture shows that a torch contains so many things like electric bulb, light switch, plastic casing, then bulb and reflector. Now, can you say why this reflector is there? That is nearer to the bulb. Why there is presence of reflector? What is the main function of reflector in a bulb? So that the light can easily diverge from that point and it will reflect in a wider way. Okay? Understood this point? What is the main function of reflector? Okay, very good. Now comes to electric conductor and insulator. In previous class, I have told you in a very short definition that what is conductor and what is insulator. Just an idea I have just gave you, what is conductor and what is insulator. Now, conductor means those materials which allow electricity to pass through them. Okay? Conductor means those materials which allow electricity to pass through them. These are called conductor. Now, what is insulator? Just opposite of it, materials that do not allow electricity to pass through them. In case of, on the basis of conductor of heat also, we can divide materials into two category. One is conductor of heat and insulator of heat. As you have already learned what is conductor and Okay, now in this portion, that is the conductor of electricity and insulator of electricity, means on the basis of conductivity of electricity, we can divide or we can categorize the materials into two categories. One is conductor, another is insulator. Okay, any problem up to this portion, students? You can tell me now. Now, one thing, that all metals are good conductor of electricity, means they are conductor of electricity. Some are more good conductor, some are medium conductor of electricity. Not all are equal, okay? And non-metals are mainly insulator, okay? But there is an exception, graphite. Graphite, you know, that is found in the lead pencil, drawing pencil. So that is made of graphite, that is a non-metal, and this is a good conductor of electricity, and our body also a good conductor of electricity. Okay, so be careful when you handle or whenever you just touch the switchboard at home. Okay, so you must remember this point, that our body is also a good conductor of electricity. Okay, so be aware of that. I hope you understood. Now I am writing the major differences between conductor and insulator. Just try to follow me. Okay, students, try to follow me. Yes, very good, Deeptak. I have told it, no? Please mute your microphone. Who have not muted their microphone? This is my request to all of you.
Please mute the microphone.
Who have not muted their microphone? Let me know. Okay. Let's start the difference between conductor and insulator. Okay. Can you see the board properly, everyone? Students, can you see the board properly? There I am writing conductor in the left side and insulator in the right side. Okay. Now, from the point of view, first point I can differentiate between conductor and insulator. That is the first point you must write. Materials. Materials which permit the electric current to pass through it. Okay, this is the first point. Now in insulator, you must write the first point, materials that restrict the electric current to pass through it. This is the first point of view. We can differentiate between conductor and insulator. Okay. Now, second point, you must write that conductor are used for making electric wires and cables. So, you can write conductors are used for making electric wires and cables. Okay, this is second point of difference. Now, in the second point, in case of insulator, you must write one point that insulators are used for separating the current carrying separating the current carrying conductor and for supporting electrical appliances. Okay, electrical appliances or equipments you can write. Okay, understood this point everyone? Insulator is used for separating the current carrying conductors and for supporting electrical appliances. Any problem up to this portion? Second point of difference. Any problem, students? No problem. Okay, very good. Let's come to another difference by example. As you know, the example you can write, you can easily write it. Example of a conductor, copper, then silver. Aluminium, you can also write graphite. Okay, if you collect so many conductors name, then you can write. Okay, yes, I'm giving sign. Now you can write example of conductors: copper, silver, aluminium, graphite also. And again I'm writing in this portion, that is example of insulator. These are wood, paper, plastic, no? These all are example of insulator. So have you written this portion everyone? Any problem up to this portion? And in the next class we will discuss about question answer from this topic. This may be your from your offline class you will get your exercise question answer. So please follow ePortal regularly. This is my request to all of you to check your ePortal regularly. There I may inform you that whether any offline video is uploaded or not. Okay students, so try to follow ePortal regularly. Now is it clear to you everyone? Have you written all of you? Okay, write it. Okay.